That tends to happen when you play a Zero against two melee champions. Also, Cadral's on a ward, and that's not good when he loses E.
Uh-oh, Broxah flash and chomp. Cadral is gonna have to burn everything. He's first blooded by Caps.
A Lucian as your only damage source isn't gonna cut it.
I agree. Bone Skewer pulls and Shook. He gets a two-man belly bop there, and Promiscue's actually arrived. But so is Caps and Cadral. Let's see, this 3v3, it's getting a little wonky right now.
It's a 4v3.
In comes Soas. Can he get the knock in the wall? Oh, Promiscue! That was a promise of death. You know, leaving some head scratching going on here for what H2K were doing. Cadral already locked up. He's actually gonna have to fly forward. And Hextech ultimatum on. There's the jungle double team. Broxah, you can't beat both junglers, or maybe you can't! He gets the 1v1 outplay! Are you kidding me?
Yeah, Trundle with that ultimate is pretty wild.
Okay.
Right there, and W, he pressed his Q, all those
skill shots. It's a skill button, dude. Come on, don't knock it. Oh, wait a second. That's a better bonus Q. They pulled back Promise Q. He is getting chunked while the turret falls in the mid. That is a lot of Swain damage. He's been quietly stacking it up as well. Getting close to that Rod of Ages. Death from below. Sheriff will have to dash and dodge, but it's not going to be enough, and they tag team it with the never move. Hillisang even tanking. He will fall to stop this aggression, but Promiscue says, no, this is not today. Shook, going to get a knock-in onto Caps, turns it around. Once again, the damage is there. Emperor's Divide. Caps is on enemy lines, though. Let's see if they can go forward. Sheriff flashing aggressively back into Caps, who flashes even further. The Culling is not going to take him down, but the Gragas will. His luck definitely ran out, and Hillisang falls down as well. So Fnatic give up a couple of kills, and that's hope for H2K.
Now Shook is sitting 2-0 on his mid lane Gragas. He's popping off, man.
Looking for Soas, trying to take advantage of that aggression. Unstoppable for Soas, flashes the teleport. It's going to come a little bit late. There's the Keeper's Verdict, but Soas, he gets the outplay before he dies. They get more kills, they get more gold.
And usually they don't turn around 1v3s, but maybe this time.
Soas, Keeper's Verdict. Oh, he's going to only find one. He does get the knock into the wall, but yeah, not going to live that long. So H2K are finding picks. Credit to them. Have tried mixed impacts. Sheriff going to get found out. Hillisang is there with the death from below, but not nearly enough damage. And Sheriff just gets deleted. Hillisang's going to live for a moment before Smitty J comes with a flank around the side. Nonetheless, Whippo gets the double kill, and the rest of H2K are way too late to do anything about it.
Fortunately for H2K, Cadral wasn't there for them in that fight. And now Fnatic actually,
Hello! Bye, Caps!
That's AP Gragas, baby! He's got the Runic Echoes, 7 stacks on the Dark Seal, but Fnatic still are winning the fights and take down yet another turret. It's relatively squishy with this Black Cleaver build.
Okay, be able to find him. There goes the Shard and the Keeper's Verdict.
Boink.
Knocks the Malphite away. He tries to dash away and dodge away, but it's not going to be enough. Cadral and Shook still sticking on him like glue. And even the big barrel spent. Shook picks up his 4th kill of the game, but meanwhile, Caps and Hillisang going in on Sheriff. Promiscue does get a block off for just a second. This is, it's kooky action everywhere.
Those are the plays you need to keep seeing from H2K, but what do they lose on the back half?
They might lose Shook's life for the time being, and that is a lot of damage. Sheriff spends a full Culling channel in, but it's not going to be enough. They're cutting through those defenses. Sheriff flashes away. Whippo follows through. Cadral comes in to try and give a little bit of relief, but he's going to get melted in the blink of an eye. And all of a sudden, it's only Smitty J at this point. He's going down one way or another here, Ender.
Yeah, they're gonna be chasing him down. Not for that long, because they have so much CC to keep him right there.
Who don't seem too keen to take a fight today.
Oh,
they got him. Cadral, he's not able to find anything. Hextech ultimatum. Meanwhile, though, Caps does go down. Can H2K take this fight? I don't know about that one. It looks like a little low on the health bars, flashing away. They found Whippo. So you said it, Ender, and it did happen. That it's kind of hard to expect it, and how much damage you can actually do once you've got that Trinity Force up and available. Fnatic do pull Smitty J back in, never move, and they knock him into the wall. Oh my goodness, nowhere to go. Caps picks that one up. It's now a 4v5. Sheriff spends the Culling channel. Only going to tickle the health bars of Fnatic. So they decided they just wanted to take a fight, and
yeah,
they got
like,
it.
You built Trinity for some Malphite. Oh, we can just one-shot you. Say Fnatic and onto the...
Well, that was dirty, and you know what? It didn't cost Fnatic a thing.
Maybe they combo it down. Certainly
all right,
possible.
Caps waiting around the side. Actually, Cadral going into the wall, but he does not get a chance to smite down the Baron. He lasted approximately a fraction of a second.
Yeah, he didn't want to go to that party. Even though he got the invitation, Caps basically dragged him into the pit. Now Shook has to make the hero play.
Trying, but he's getting forced away once again. That's a lot of Sand Soldiers, and there will be no attempt at a hero steal. And I don't even know if there'll be any chance for him to live through it all. Look at the wave in the top as well. H2K, they're losing everything on this map.
And of course, you have Whip and the rest of the team actually fighting the mid.
There we go. Gadriel trying to find the pick off onto Caps. Doesn't work this time around.
Okay.
Channeled. And then Hillisang finally going to fall. But Whippo standing tall, and the rest of H2K are not going to live through this one. Whippo flashing the wall on this Sheriff, trying to dash. Relentless retreat away. Here comes Shook on the flank, but it's still a 2v3 if he even wanted to take it. And, well, make that one member standing. This tower soon to fall. Caps, he's hit the full late game scaling mode. And once again, Smitty J goes unstoppable force, not nearly going to be enough. Whippo going golden, and the rest of the team going into the back line. However, it looks like the Pike is going down, and Cadrill just desperately trying to keep everyone alive. Meanwhile, those minions are wailing away at the Nexus turrets of H2K. Fnatic, well, in this base, they're here to stay.
Yeah, Whippo's just way too strong right now. Sheriff, Promiscue, Shook, they're trying to do their best, but they just can't make it happen.
Yeah, there's that steadfast presence once again, and Fnatic stay steadfast, say that five times fast, in the base of H2K, and with the last of the Nexus turrets falling, they didn't fall for the trickery at all. Fnatic improve to 9-3.
Coming in hot against the AP, Gragas, jungle mid lane, we don't know what it is.
What do we call that? Double jungle is like the closest I can think, but whatever it was.